And there are so many of this around us, and we can see them in every place. Some people who take the verses of the Quran and who make commentary of these verses according to their whims. Some people who take the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they say this hadith is not valid now. It was valid at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but not anymore. So it's not valid. So we will not work with it. Those people who say, for example, for the sixth of the say hijab was at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when ladies were primitives and they did not go outside Arabia or Medina. But now, with the globalization, now with the traveling oversized and in every place, and ladies are studying at the universities, so there is no more need for hijab. They changed the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah says in the Quran, فَأَذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ, for the riba, for the interest that you take from the bank. And you find a lot of people nowadays who are not thinking about the interest, and it's, and they say this was in the Quran, and that text is a traditional one that was good for certain time and certain era and certain people, but it's not good for me now. I'm living in Australia and I don't have a house, so I go for the first house using the riba. What about the verse? What about the thing that you read in the Quran? Allah says, الَّذِينَ يَأْكُلُونَ الرِّبَى لَا يَقُومُونَ إِلَّا كَمَا يَقُومُ الَّذِي يَتَخَبَّطُهُ الشَّيْطَانُ مِنَ الْمَسِ. Allah make it embarrassing between those who eat the interest and the riba and those whose shaitan is moving them around, whose shaitan is killing them. So this is the change, this is the disease of the shubha, or the suspicion in some of the laws or the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third kind of the disease of the hearts are the ghafla. It is the negligence. That means the diseases of negligence. That means he forgets about everything. He forgets that there is one end of this life. He forgets that one day he's going to die. He is busy all the time with his business. He is busy all the time with his family. He does not think that one day he will be back to Allah. Allah says in the Quran, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. He does not think about this. One day we will be all back to Allah. We say every day, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. We say all of us, we belong to Allah, and one day we will be back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they spend their days full of happiness, seeking or looking for something that makes them happy or funny, and they do not think that one day they will cry. One day they will eat even their fingers out of their pity, out of their anger, that they did not practice or go through the ways of the Prophet ﷺ. Allah says in the Quran, وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَىٰ يَدَيْهِ. He eats his hands. He bites them, he eats them. Some of the commentators of the Quran, they say he eats the whole hands, even the arm. وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَىٰ يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. He says at that day, I wish that I was with the Prophet. I wish that I followed the path of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. يَا وَيْلَتَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. لَقَدْ وكان الشيطان للإنسان خذولا. He will feel a lot of pity that day. But it's not good. It's out of time. There is no work. At the day of judgment, at the day when people are resurrected in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they cannot do anything at that day. It's just whether you have your book with your right hand. Then you say, هَاُقْرَأُوا كِتَابِيَا إِن فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ فِي جَنَّةٍ عَالِيَةٍ قُطُوفُهَا دَانِيَةٍ. And those people, the great losers. The great loser is not someone who loses some pounds or some kilos of his body. Wallahi, he is not. Because they put the emphasis on the body. So the one who loses some kilos or some pounds, they say, he's a great loser. Wallahi, the great loser is the one who comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at that day and he goes to the hellfire. Allah says in the Quran, وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالِهِ فَيَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أُوتَ كِتَابِيَهْ وَلَمْ أَدْرِ مَا حِسَابِيَهْ يَا لَيْتَهَا كَانَتِ الْقَاضِيَةَ مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيَهْ هَلَكَ عَنِّي سُلْطَانِيَهْ No money will benefit you that day. No business will benefit you that day. No son or daughter will benefit you that day. What is the result? خُذُوهُ فَغُلُّوهُ الله أكبر. الله أكبر. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to come to that person, the weak person, خُذُوهُ 70,000 of the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those people who were created to guard the fire, will come to him. خُذُوهُ فَغُلُّوهُ ثم الجحيم صلوه. Put him in the hellfire. إنه كان لا يؤمن بالله العظيم. He used to spend his life in a very funny way. إنه كان لا يؤمن. He did not believe in Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ولا يحب على طعام المسكين. Then these are the symptoms. These are the kinds of the diseases of the heart. Now what about the symptoms? The symptoms are also of three kinds. It is either a disease, an ill heart, or diseased heart, or a blind heart, or a dead heart. Is there any difference between them? Yes! The diseased heart is a heart that can be cured. Is a heart that can, if you look for your heart, if you diagnose the problem of your heart, then you can fix it while you're still alive. And the blind heart is the heart that does not know that he is blind. And does not know that one day he will be resurrected and asked about every single thing that he used to do. The blind man is not the man that cannot see. The blind lady is not the blind lady with the sides. The blind lady is the lady that cannot see by the heart. Allah says in the Quran, فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَى الْأَبْصَارِ Your sight is not blind. What is blind? It is the heart. وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَى الْقُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ And this is also another دليل, another indication that the spiritual heart is in the chest, inside the chest. And some of the scholars, they say it's near the physical heart. So dear brothers, your main important and significant job in this life is to figure out how can you make your heart a sound one? How can you cure your heart? And do not put your emphasis, do not put your stress on your body, because the body can cure itself. It is also required that you take care of your body, you take care of my sister, of your beauty, you take care of your health, my brother, but at the end of the day, do not think that this will let you be away from the hellfire at the day of judgment. You have to put the more emphasis, the more stress, the more education, the more importance is on the spiritual heart. Now, I'd like you to see your hearts. Every one of us tonight is going to make a test for his heart. I want you to see whether your heart is a sound heart or not. We will go through the steps of the diseased hearts. We will see the problems of the diseased heart. And I want you, after every one of them, to ask yourself, is it the same for you, my brother, my sister? Am I suffering the same thing? Am I feeling the same thing? Then your heart is diseased. If your heart is not experiencing the same feeling, then alhamdulillah, your heart is a sound one.